Signori, questo è un vecchio amico mio, colonnello Hans Landa della SS.
Buongiorno.
Welcome to Overthinking It, where we subject the popular culture to a level of scrutiny it probably doesn't deserve. Mark Lee here with the latest installment in our Eurovision 2013 review. In case you've forgotten, and I won't blame you if you have, Italy was once home to the Roman Empire. At its height, it controlled most of Europe and parts of North Africa and the Middle East. But since those Salad days, Italy has had trouble conquering Europe in any way at all, and that includes Eurovision. After 1997, they dropped out of the competition for 14 years before reappearing in 2011. 14 years! They didn't even show up to play! It's less Veni, Vidi, Vici, and more Veni, Vidi, whatever. It's less friends, Romans, countrymen, lend me your ears, and more friends, Romans, countrymen, look at all the f**ks that I give. In their last 2 years in the competition, they placed second and ninth, so maybe they're on their way back. This year's entry is by Marco Mengoni, and it's called L'Essenziale, or The Essential. This song is a reasonably competent piano ballad, but nothing to write home about. Italy must be banking on two things to make this dominate Europe. One, Marco's astounding hairdo. His hair height to body height ratio is rivaled only by Moran Mazor of Israel. Two, his uncanny ability to sing while underwater. I mean, this is incredible. Does this guy have gills? Is he the result of a secret Italian government project to create aquatic super soldiers? This is a quantum leap for Eurovision gimmicks. Other countries will be desperate to up their games to match this. In coming years, I anticipate we'll see Eurovision contestants singing while suspended in midair, while on fire, and while frozen in carbonite. I can't wait for Eurovision 2014. And for Italy's aquatic, water-breathing troops to conquer Europe and restore the Roman Empire to its former glory. Until that time comes, you can enjoy our continuing coverage of Eurovision 2013. Subscribe to our channel, leave a comment below, and visit us on the web at overthinkingit.com, where we subject the popular culture to a level of scrutiny it probably doesn't deserve.